Good morning, Celonauts, and welcome back to beautiful Bavaria. We're here in Munich, Germany, day two of Celosphere. My name is Savannah Peterson, bringing you all the insights and inspo with Rob Strechay. Rob, our next guest is a total VIP and a CUBE regular.
Yeah. I mean, he was just on recently from the NYSE, and I it's great to have him back here again, so this is great.
Good Welcome to see you guys. Back to the show, Alex.
Yeah,
we're
good
so
to see
grateful
you
to have
back
you.
Back in Munich, right?
Yeah, this is fantastic. Yeah.
You love Oktoberfest, so you got
I was going to say, I've been here twice
You're
in like the
Munich poster boy.
Savannah, when are you coming to Oktoberfest?
Hopefully next year.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, we got to make it happen.
See, now that I have tables that I can renew now,
it's like
I have to renew.
Is that how it works?
Yes.
Yeah, that's how it works.
Oh, wow. I didn't realize. Yeah. VIP. Well, amazing. You learn something new every day. Speaking of learning something new, y'all have grown a lot since the last time we saw you. If I heard Karsten right last night, you've grown 4x in 6 months in terms of your customer base?
Yes, I mean, especially when you look at the customers that are adopting our process intelligence graph, that's been really a strong driver of growth for us. Yeah.
That must feel amazing. What's it like for you to be in the room here?
Well, I mean, Celosphere is like Disneyland for process intelligence enthusiasts, and you can definitely count me under this. No, it's really exciting. I mean, seeing so many old friends, a lot of new friends, and it's the biggest Celosphere ever. You know, we are.
Congratulations. How many of us are here then?
I think we have over 3,500.
Wow. Nice.
So, yeah, it's been growing nicely.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
I mean, I look at it, and I think, again, you guys did a great job with the keynote yesterday. One of the best that I mean, we go to a lot of these, and I don't speak
That's really
lightly.
Saying something,
Thank
honestly.
You.
Yeah, no, we were moved. It was
moving. It was very on point, and I really like, you can't really do AI without PI.
Right.
And I think when I take a step back, you know, beyond freeing the process and all of that, I start to look at the ROI of AI and the ROI. AI, and it's like a little tongue twister there.
Good morning, tongue twister,
yes,
there you go.
Absolutely. When you start to see this AI wave really pushing, to me, if you're going to do agents right, you really have to understand the processes.
Right.
Have you been seeing where you're being brought into these places where POCs have stalled, or maybe they haven't gone as well as they thought, and they're trying to rethink their process of AI, and they're saying, hey, you know, we need to know why it didn't work from that perspective and map out that process.
Yeah, exactly. I think you're spot on. You know, when we look at the data, IDC came out with a study that only 11% of companies are getting any type of measurable benefit from their AI investments. So on the one side, we all know AI is going to change the world, and it's going to transform our companies. We believe that the future of the enterprise is AI-driven and composable. So it's very, very exciting. You're thinking of operations that are much more automated, right? Where AI automates what we do, transformed business processes. You look at much more adaptable companies that can change much more quickly, adapt. And then the reality is that, you know, the return isn't visible yet. And at this scale, anywhere the scale or magnitude that we expect. And it's really because you need to look under the covers and make sure that you understand your processes and you reimagine your processes. If you just use an AI agent here or there, it's not really going to move the needle in terms of business outcomes. And that's why we say there's no AI without PI. You know, when we really look at it, there's three things AI needs, right? It needs an understanding of the context of how your business runs, right? If it doesn't have that, and it doesn't have that crucial information, it can't really automate for you. Secondly, it needs to be deployed in the right places strategically, because you're looking at giant organizations. I mean, we have a lot of the biggest companies in the world here, and they need to deploy it in the right places. And three, it needs to work and integrate in your processes to work with everything else that you're already doing.
So when we look at that 11%, when we look at that data, that's overall, those obviously aren't just Celonis companies. Would you say, and I realize this might be an estimate, would you say that there's a greater success rate once companies implement you that's dramatically different?
I would say absolutely. I mean, we see a huge amount of increase, 3 to 4x in terms of customers adopting our process intelligence graph. You know, we see tremendous momentum in our AI offerings on top of that. And we are doing it in a composable architecture with partnerships, right? We had Juniper and Microsoft on stage yesterday. A really, really exciting story of how they're agentifying their core operations across maintenance, finance, supply chain, across all the, basically all the business, using process intelligence and then Microsoft AI agents on top of that. And this is really what, you know, makes AI work, enterprise AI work, right? We are not talking about AI, we're talking about enterprise AI.
Right.
Which is not about LLMs or agents or just one technology. It's about a combination. Operational intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, generative AI, agentic AI, and the discipline of infusing this into your operations. That's what we're talking about, and this is not possible without process intelligence.
That ecosystem is so key.
Yes.
And especially for you, as you're growing at this velocity, what's it like for you as co-founder to evaluate the right partners to pull into that ecosystem?
I mean, it's very simple. We do the right thing for the customer. Right, customers love to use it. We did a big announcement yesterday with Databricks. Customers love to use Databricks.
Right.
So we have zero copy integrations. Customers love to use Microsoft. We have zero copy integrations. We integrate seamlessly with agentic and Copilot frameworks. You know, so we really partner, we will take, let our customers, you know, take us.
Yeah.
You know, we believe that good things grow from open ecosystems.
And I think you also had Bloomfilter and you had a number of others.
He makes it sound
others.
So easy.
Yeah, I mean, well.
I love that, Alex.
I think one of the things that as we look at how you're bringing that composable together, and we agree, by the way, I think, you know, in the research that we've done, we look at it and we don't think there's any one company that's going to own AI. I think it's going to take a village and an ecosystem, as you talked about yesterday on the main stage. When you look at that ecosystem, and like you said, Databricks with using Delta sharing and being able to get into that ecosystem that they have, do you look at that as a way to also, it helps beyond your sharing that data into it so that agents that are built on top of their data lakes and things like that, but people are breaking down data silos. That seems to be a theme as well as what you're trying to lean into.
100%. I think data silos are, you know, not conducive to having to reimagining your processes, because we believe in freeing the process. Free the process. Free the process from the restrictions of current legacy architectures and allow it to seamlessly integrate and operate in a different way. And this is where I think, to your point, it is about an ecosystem. And you mentioned Bloomfilter, which is exciting. What we've said is, well, there's so many different use cases that are very domain and vertically specific that Celonis, we provide a horizontal platform. We give the building blocks. So we have more and more partners, ISVs, that are, their sole focus is to compose the solutions for different domains. And Bloomfield is a great example. Aaron is a great example. They are doing it for the HR space, the human capital space. Bloomfield is doing it for the software development lifecycle space. Mercatus is doing it for asset reliability and maintenance. So there's so many of those apps popping up. You can see many of them here at Celosphere. We're very excited about that momentum, because then the customer can just get started much, much faster. So the ecosystem is about those specialized ISVs as well.
That's a nice layer on top, because it allows you to truly provide solutions across the board. I mean, it makes so much sense. You know, they always say you market to everyone, you market to no one, but with your partners, you're able to provide these really specific solutions. What would you say is the most exciting part about where you are this year versus where you were last year?
So you can think about our platform in three layers, right? And the pros intelligence platform that enables enterprise AI is three layers. The one is the data core, which just went GA yesterday. And this is really the most scalable, low latency and open data infrastructure for process intelligence in the world, by far. So it brings together data from systems, devices, you know, task information, unstructured data, zero copy data integration with the major players. I mean, it really is a very, very exciting development, and we've put a lot of investment in that. That's the foundation. Second step is the heart, the process intelligence graph. And the process intelligence graph got a lot richer. So it doesn't just represent your process data across systems, right? The object-centric data model, but it also now incorporates business context, you know, KPIs, benchmarks, but also process models, enterprise architecture diagrams. So it's evolving into this richer and richer digital twin, to truly represent your business operations. There's also been a lot of maturity. You know, as I said, there's been tremendous growth in terms of customer adoption. We have over 100 customer-run sessions at Celosphere this year. You know, in the last years, we put out a lot of groundbreaking new ideas. You know, it's a show me.
Show me. Show versus tell.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And over 100 customer-run sessions tells you something.
That's impressive. I want to acknowledge
and
that.
And by the way,
that's so cool.
We didn't have slots for more, right? They were really lining up to tell their stories. So
amazing.
The process intelligence graph has matured a lot in terms of enterprise readiness capability, but also gotten a lot richer. And then you have our build experience, which is really built to design to support the full AI lifecycle, analyze the process, design the future, and operate AI-driven composable processes. So that's the platform, how it came together. Then you have all the innovation and partnerships that complement you know, our momentum and are very, very key as we talked about. I think those are probably the most exciting. You think?
It does, you can feel the evolution and the maturation within the team as well as your partner ecosystem, us on
Thank
the
you.
Desk.
Yes.
Yeah, no, it's very palpable, and the stories and the data back it up. One big conversation, obviously, that everyone's having right now is time to value.
Yes.
And I would imagine you've been able to shorten that time to value over the last year. How quickly are folks realizing value from the day they commit to implementing Celonis and increasing their process intelligence?
And this is something we're bringing down and we're continuing to bring down. It's a big part of our strategy. That's about user experience, that's about maturity, but it's also about those ISVs and partnerships, right? If you think about zero copy, right? If you think about all the vertically specific or domain specific ISVs we talked about that provide like pre-built process intelligence, that obviously accelerates time to value. So it's all those things together where customers can get, you know, I've seen customers now getting a positive return on their investment within 2 or 3 months. And that's something we want to bring to every customer, that type of experience, and we see very good progress.
So,
I mean, by the way, changing and really reinventing processes in large companies is not easy.
No.
And it used to take years.
Yeah.
So the fact that you're saying one month is remarkable.
Maybe it's a couple, maybe it's 2 to 3, but we are making progress and we are really making it easier and more repeatable all the time.
Yeah, I mean, we even had Deutsche Telekom where they had started with you and then they came back to you when you changed from a use case to more object-driven process mapping.
That's a good point. One of the things, Vinma, we had the CEO on stage, and they are really deploying Celonis very strategically across the business, and they've really, really leaned in to really enable autonomous and AI-driven operations. And one of the things he said on stage, which made all of us proud, was to say, it's a very different company today than the company we partnered with just a few years back, right? So,
I was going to actually ask you about him.
Gotta feel good.
Because, I mean, he was fantastic, by the way, and I thought all three of your customers that you had on stage with Uniper and Mercedes-Benz also rounding that out, when you looked at it, they were all in different stages of their life cycle with you and using you in different use cases and for different parts of the product. Fantastic use of that. When you look at Vinmar in particular, they were the furthest along with their AI and their AI journey. And, you know, he talked about it, and the change is hard because it's the processes were changing. How do you see that being kind of almost like that use case plays out? That would seem to be a use case that plays out in every industry, not
100%.
Just theirs.
And I think for them, you know, order to cash, very complex distribution, right? Very large amount of transactions. And yes, it's about cost, but for them it's really about growth because they are growing fast. And they are thinking about how can we get our people more productive and handle more transactions and deliver better service to our customers. And they said, well, just putting improvements in the process is great, but we actually want to reinvent the process and using Celonis as a foundation. And he said they have three strategic platforms. It's Microsoft, SAP, and Celonis. Those are the three strategic bets in the IT stack. And Celonis is really enabling them to reinvent the entire order to cash experience on a layer that's decoupled and abstracted from current architecture. And I think this was a great story. And you know, they said that the supply chain team is already 40% more productive.
Wow.
And they have ideas to take this forward. Yeah, that's what he said yesterday. So it's exciting. It's working in conjunction with the other vendors and the other things they're doing, right? It's been a great story, and we look hopefully to replicate this. Yeah. With many other customers.
But to your point, they didn't pick the easiest part. It was the $3 billion of their $4 billion business. I mean, it was the largest part of their
casual
business. So I thought that was fantastic.
And by the way, this is something we see more and more, where people go more into the mission critical areas of the business because that's where it moves the needle the most.
Yeah,
and absolutely. That's when we talk about, you know, deploying it in the right places. That's what it's all about.
Yeah.
I bet you have a lot of those conversations with your customers.
Yes.
Everyone's trying to figure out what to do. I feel like nobody knows what to do half the time, so it's nice of you to guide them. What do you hope to be able to say when we have the pleasure of sitting down at Celosphere 2026 that you can't yet say today?
Well, I see you at Celosphere 2026, but I think this idea of the AI-driven and composable enterprise, I think we'll have even more proof points, kind of like with the process intelligence graph. Today we just see so much momentum, right? That's something we talked about a year ago. You know, now everybody's showing how they're doing it, and I think you'll see a lot of momentum there. We have some things we're working on that I won't talk about,
right?
Because I want to make sure you come back next year. You know,
such a tease, so, Alex.
Yeah, that's great. That's
great. Oh, that's awesome. Well, we can't wait to continue telling your stories. Fantastic. And seriously, congratulations to you and the team. You do such
Thank
a brilliant
you.
Job
Thank
from
you.
The branding
great.
To the case studies.
I can only give that back. I watch your show all the time. And
Thank you.
Because you really go deep, and we really appreciate you having you here.
Yep. No, we're glad to be here with
you. It's a joy.
So, thank you.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes.
Appreciate it.
And thank all of you for tuning in to our fantastic Power Pack, 2 days of live coverage here from Celosphere in Munich, Germany. My name is Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.